Hey guys, welcome to the finals. This hand, yeah, I guess we keep it. Not that exciting. I think we really need like a Dwinen's Lead or something, so we could go turn one trapper, or even like an Elvish Mystic. So we can go turn one trapper, turn two trapper, two drop, and then actually start courting fairly soon. Just playing a Shaman of the Pack on two doesn't seem that exciting to me. We're a bit low on black mana, which is why I'm leading with Trapper, because Trapper filters black mana into green mana anyway, and then it's one less black card in my hand. The next turn I can go Mystic plus Trapper, and then either fire off Shaman, or more likely Cord for Reclamation Sage on three. Depending on what my opponent does. Revoker. Okay. Well, can't really play the Hollow this turn. On the plus side, I can still Cord fine. The Revoker doesn't stop me from courting. Chief's good. It's a fine card. Sylvan Messenger is okay. I think I just want to blow up his chief, though. Blow up his chief and start landing shamans. Yeah. If I wait, it gives him something to Shrapnel Blast, but he's got random things to sack to Shrapnel Blast anyway, and this way he might put a Scissors on something, and then we can blow it up before it gets to deal us damage. And he's, like, declaring his Ornithopters as attackers, so now they're not going to be blockers. Well, that sucked. Alright, guess we take two here. Not the end of the world. Just find a Reclamation Sage anyway. The old Whirler Rogue. It's a lot of bodies. It's a lot of bodies, that's for sure. So we got some options here. I think I'm just gonna Rex Sage, kill the Chief. And then Elvish Visionary. So I guess I should lead with Elvish Visionary. And then that would play the Jungle Hollow this turn. The other line is to Nissa, get a forest, and then use that to Rex Sage, but I think this is a little bit better. Okay. Well, now I'd rather Elvish Mystic plus Rex Sage. Just start to get damage in. The more damage we can do to him, the better the Shaman of the Pack gets. Ugh. Another Chief. That's brutal. And you can tap that Chief and the Springleaf Drum to make either the Revoker or the Whirler Rogue unblockable. I think he's got me in a turn 2 clock here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yeah, easily a turn 2 clonk. Anything I can do about that? I think I need to, like, rip either a cord or another Shaman of the Pack. Shaman of the Pack is good, like it domes him for 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or something like that. Oh, maybe we can just kill him. Because he can block here, and then take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 plus 9 is 16. So we're damage short. That's pretty unfortunate. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... Yeah, that's like a tap of a mana confluence away. Oh well, I mean... Playing the Nissa can't possibly be better. See him like accidentally blocking the wrong creature. Not very likely, but no reason not to serve. No, he blocks the right one. Close game though, huh? Close game. Ah, Ghostfire Blade. Wonder if I could have squeaked in a point of damage somewhere. I almost bluffed a point earlier. Stubborn Denial. They don't all main deck Stubborn Denial, but some of them do. I wonder if it's worth playing around in general. So I always bring in the three Unravel the Aethers, which is fine, and I'm always unsure if I should be bringing in the Ulcerates and the Minister of Pain. I like the Thought Seizes for sure. I think Archfiend's good. Nissa's a little bit slow. And... Thornbow Archer is okay. Obnixilis is obviously slow, and the Haruspex. This is not the matchup for that card. I think I'm gonna leave the Thornbow Archer in because I'm on the play. And it's an efficient little dude, whatever. Smitterino. Yeah, what a close game. Single life point, man. Single life point. Okay. I'll rock this. We're missing a black source, but I'm sure our deck will catch up. We got some elven synergies, we got a cantrip, we have a 187 creature. Playing the Visionary in case I draw or comes into play tapped land. So good. Instead of playing the forest from my hand and then playing the Visionary off of that, or like bluffing an attack with the Elvish Mystic. Anyway. Science Din Soul Artifact up the flyer, which I am very happy with. Let's dig around in that big old brain of yours. Revoker, which I don't really care about. I think I'm just going to take the Chief of the Foundry out of this hand. Either that or the Hanger Bank. Probably the Chief. Kablooey. So now he gets to play Hanger Bank and move the Ghostfire Blade onto it. Oh no, he's revoking. Okay. I guess that's fine. Gives him a chance of playing the Hanger Bank with two counters instead of one. Name's Elvish Mystic, sure. I'm not sure which to play here. Get to tag for more damage if I play the elite, though, so I guess I'll play that. Whereas the trapper would allow me to start trading damage. Trading guys for damage, like, thanks to the death touch. Do I attack here? I don't think so. Maybe I do. I guess I'd rather crack the Hangerback Walker than just let it keep growing. So it'd be 6 attackers. He gets to eat the 2 2Xs, so he takes 4 and goes to 14. Never mind, I'm just gonna let his Hangerback grow. Whatever. I think once we've, like, quasi-stabilized at this point, he doesn't have any flyers. I think we can sit here for a little bit. And, I don't know, find an Archfiend or something. That's a good draw. Do we serve with everybody then? Because we could hold this guy back to kill the, whatever this thing blocks. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Yeah, this is okay. Just making sure that the Revoker doesn't get to survive. Yeah, if he activates the Hangerback, I'm not giving that Elvish Visionary Death Touch. I will not crack your Hangerback for you, sir. Easy way to give him a lot of value out of nowhere. Okay. I am prepared for damage. Sure. So his last card could be Shrapnel Blast, in which case he would, like, kill my lord pre-damage, and then not take that much, but then at least I'm getting the Shrapnel Blast out of his hand, and preventing him from just growing this thing. It's still not exactly good for me. It looks like that's his last card, too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 damage. At least that's a reasonable amount of damage. And I guess we keep the Visionary, which we would lose otherwise. Still not very exciting. Yeah, he definitely sends it at the Lord. Alright. And it gets a... What did he sacrifice? He sacrificed a land. He didn't sack his walker. Interesting. Maybe he's banking on ripping another Shrapnel Blast? I don't know. I don't get it. Oh, Seismic Rupture off the top. That's pretty good. Yeah, alright. That was kind of a close game. Two very close games. Rough way to go there. But, so it goes. And at least we made the finals. And we got to see a few different matchups, huh? That's all cool. And I will, thanks everybody for watching, and I will see you all next week. Obviously, if you wanted to tighten this list up a bit, the Obnixilis is really just here as a challenge slot. Like, I just really want a cord for this guy in response to a fetch, and it hasn't happened yet, so it's gonna stay here in my list, but I don't expect you guys to play him. The sideboard is fairly tight. I like it all a decent amount. The double back to natures seem excessive until you play against the green-white enchantment stack, and then it's pretty necessary. Grim didn't seem bad. I like the one of three drops as cord targets. Three Thoughtseize is really good. We never drew the Thornbow Archer. I'm not really sure if it belongs or not, but it's there. It's not really like the one Thornbow Archer. It's just kind of like the ninth one drop, you know. It just helps us curve out a little bit sometimes. One Sylvan Messenger has been okay. Maybe that's what the Obnix list should be, just like a second Sylvan Messenger. I don't hate that. Well, anyway, see you guys next week. And if you guys have been playing Elves, you got some sweet Elves lists, feel free to fire them off in the forums. This is, after all, just like a kind of a budgety, fun creation that's also like fairly competitive. I'm sure that this deck could be improved upon. That's kind of what I'm doing here, is working at that. We'll be right back.